Hey everyone, I'm a big fan of dual booting. Both my laptop and my Homelab NAS have both Windows and Linux installed on them, allowing me to freely switch between both operating systems. This kind of gives people the best of both worlds, especially if you're interested in testing out Linux, for example, but you don't quite have the confidence to go ahead and completely nuke your Windows install just yet. But some people still have concerns. For example, if you have a Dell or HP laptop which had Windows pre-installed, would you void your warranty if you then install Ubuntu or Mint on it? And can dual booting actually slow down your PC at all? Well, I wanted to cover these questions and more in today's video, because while dual booting is usually good and has no issues at all, there certainly are some downsides to it in some cases. So firstly, can your computer's speed or performance be harmed by installing multiple operating systems on it? Well, the way that operating systems are installed on your computer is that the data drive inside your system gets split up into different bits. This is known as disk partitioning. Technically, you could just buy multiple hard drives or SSDs and install them in your computer, and then put Windows on one drive and Linux on another, for example, but in reality, you often just partition the disk, it's easier. Whichever method you choose though, with a dual boot, you can only boot up into one operating system at a time, either Windows or Linux, but never both. This is because you choose this when your computer is starting up. If you want to run both at exactly the same time, you actually need to look at virtual machines instead, and I discuss this point more towards the end of this video. But since you can only boot into one OS when dual booting, you're never going to end up in a situation where your computer is way slower because it's trying to run loads of different operating systems at the same time. That's because of how your CPU, RAM, and your disk space all work. Basically, programs and operating systems are installed on your data drives, and then everything there just sits there unused until it's actually getting opened up. When you then open up Chrome or boot into Mint, for example, this gets loaded into memory. The RAM. Your CPU will also need to do some work to actually open and run the program or operating system. Now, as your CPU and RAM, they will become slower if you try to do too much. If you open 10 browsers and each has 100 tabs, you just go crazy. Your computer will become really slow because the CPU and RAM will be maxed out and just struggle to manage all of this. The same is true of operating systems. If you use virtual machines and run too many operating systems, then your CPU and your RAM could get maxed out, resulting in your computer getting really slow. But since you can only run one operating system at a time when dual booting, this isn't an issue. There's no inherent reason why a computer will get slower simply because you've installed two or more operating systems on it. In many cases, running a dual boot can be a really good idea because Linux often runs faster than Windows 10 and 11. For example, my 6-year-old laptop is often quite slow when running Windows 10 or 11, but is super fast when I boot up into Ubuntu. So in my case, having a dual boot means that I actually speed up my PC by not using Windows, so that's great. There's only one real way the dual boot can slow down your computer, and that's if you end up maxing out all of the disk space by installing multiple operating systems. If your drives are full up, after all, then this can result in poor performance. In this case, you'll probably want to try uninstalling unused programs and also reviewing your swap space or page file configuration that your system is allocated, because this directly uses up disk space. But in all other cases, a dual boot shouldn't affect performance at all. Now we come to the harder question. Can it impact your computer's warranty? Well, it's impossible for me to say for sure because there are hundreds or probably thousands of companies that build computers. I can't say with 100% certainty that every single one of them will allow dual booting, for example. In general though, dual booting a desktop or laptop PC is just a software change. It doesn't actually affect the physical hardware inside the system. So if I was to dual boot my computer the moment I received it and then 6 months later my CPU died, a reputable computer company should have no issue taking the computer back, examining it, and then fixing it for free under the warranty. That's what reputable companies should do. But of course, not all tech companies are honest and reputable, as we know, and not every repair technician is super experienced either. For example, ASUS has quite a bad reputation with returns and RMAs, so I wouldn't really trust them personally if I purchased an ASUS Windows laptop, then I installed Linux on it, and then shipped it back to them with a hardware fault. All it takes is a single inexperienced or dishonest repair tech to say that you've made an unauthorized change to your computer, and then you're kind of stuck. Yes, you might be able to appeal any initial decision, but it'll delay things, and that's extra time you're then without your work or personal computer, which isn't ideal. So here's the thing. Most Windows computers or laptops you buy from the big tech companies will come with a built-in recovery partition that allows you to really easily restore your computer back to the default factory state. Basically back to just having Windows installed in it and nothing else. Well, sometimes they'll give you a little recovery USB that you insert into your computer, go into the boot menu and restore your PC from that USB. Either way, if I needed to return a dual booted computer or laptop, I would always restore it before shipping it back. It'll just make things easier and quicker all round. That's all great then, your PC shouldn't be any slower, and your warranty should still be in place if you dual boot. Nice. So are there any downsides to dual booting? Well, yes, there are a few which you should probably be aware of. Firstly, running a dual boot setup is a bit more complicated than simply keeping whatever operating system your laptop came with. That's because dual booting will actually modify the way the computer starts up. It changes the UEFI booter process and adds a certain bootloader so that you can select which operating system to use on startup. This often works well enough, but sometimes if you repair your OS, this bootloader can then just completely disappear, and you're stuck loading straight into a single operating system as though the other one just doesn't exist. This is especially true when reinstalling or repairing Windows, because Microsoft just doesn't play nice with other operating systems. It's likely to just say, meh, let's just put our own bootloader in place, screw any other operating system. You then need to boot into a Linux USB to repair the corrupt bootloader, which is annoying. This has happened to me multiple times, always with Windows, and it sucks every single time. Linux is much better in this sense because it detects that Windows is installed, and then ensures that its own bootloader, called grub, keeps Windows listed so you don't have any problems. Secondly, a dual boot means the hard drive or SSD will be a bit messy due to all the different partitions that get created. Now, this doesn't matter for day-to-day usage of the system, but if you find that you're running out of disk space and need to resize something, it can get quite difficult to manage, especially if you have three or more operating systems installed, because you have to try and work out which partition belongs to which operating system. The final risk of dual booting is that you end up with slightly more risk to computer. I'm not trying to be controversial here or anything, but the more software you have, the more risk you have. If you mainly boot up into Linux, for example, you might find that your Windows install is very out of date when you go to boot up, with dozens of packages that need to be installed or updated. There's then always a small risk that Windows has some zero-day exploit or something like that leaves your computer unprotected from that particular one while all the updates get installed. So with all that said, should you just run your other operating systems as a virtual machine instead? For example, you could enable the virtualization option within Windows, download VirtualBox, and then run Linux Mint, for example, easily enough as a virtual machine. That would work well, right? Well, yes, it would, sort of. It would be easier and quicker than dual booting, and if you decide that you then don't like Linux Mint, you could just delete the VM and carry on as normal with Windows. Simple. However, as I mentioned towards the start of this video, running VMs will use up more of your CPU and memory, your RAM. That's why I personally tend to prefer dual booting, but VMs certainly are great for trying out loads of different operating systems first. After all, you can't know what you don't know. There's literally hundreds of different Linux distributions out there, so if you've never used Linux at all, it would definitely make sense to get a VM and try some common distributions first, and then once you find your favorite, you will then build a dual booter. That kind of gives you the best of both worlds, in my opinion. I use Arch, by the way. Kidding. Linux humor, good times. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.